My name is Jennifer Rainho, and I'm a PhD student in the laboratory of Dr. Mario Stevenson. Here at the University of Miami, I look at how a cell that becomes infected with HIV cannot be eliminated by the immune system, and understanding why is it that the immune system, which normally can eliminate an infected cell, cannot eliminate this particular HIV-infected cell. A lot of jobs, I think, out there become an everyday same routine. And in science, it's very exciting because you learn new techniques, you're always expanding your knowledge. I was born in Newark, New Jersey, and raised before migrating to Florida. My parents are both from Portugal, my mom who migrated to Newark, New Jersey, and my dad, New York City. And that actually helped spark my interest in science. I was very lucky to be so close to a major city like New York and have tons of museums and programs that were available to me to keep my interest and spark it at a very young age in science. In high school, actually, I didn't do any science at all. I definitely had had some higher level science courses, but I was more involved in writing for the yearbook and being involved in, we had a social adventures club where we would go out and do fun stuff around the neighborhood. My focus in research didn't really come until after that. But I didn't know I wanted to be a medical researcher until actually I was an undergrad in college. I became a biology major to do more of maybe nursing or physical therapy. But actually, when I became involved in research at the undergrad level, it really excited me to be part of a research team and work on viruses in particular. So the road wasn't always easy for me getting into biomedical research. As I stated, I grew up in Newark, New Jersey, which is primarily low income, and we don't have some of the higher education available to us. So it was a lot of hard work in order to become involved in research and stick out my goals. You just need drive, endurance, and you can actually become a scientist, and it's very exciting. What fascinates me about the research is just the fact that there's been 30 years now that has been devoted towards HIV research, but scientists are still trying to figure out why is it that we cannot effectively eliminate it and cure people. So it's just very exciting that we still, after 30 years, are learning new things about what's going on in the HIV virus and field. What I hope to achieve with our research is understanding how to sensitize these cells that seem to not be able to be killed to become killed. So if you're interested in becoming a medical researcher, there's a lot of programs now that have been implemented in museums and boys and girls clubs that actually assist younger individuals that are interested in science. So really just get involved in whatever you can and learn from it, and it will get you to the next level.